When you were a kid, you gradually learned that when you saw a banana, you knew that it's a banana. Or when you saw a lemon, you knew it's a lemon. You didn't say, this is the ball. Maybe when you were very young, you said that, but gradually you learned that this is not a ball, this is a lemon. Now imagine that you had to teach your computer how to recognize a banana or a lemon. Teaching computers to learn is what is called machine learning. And machine learning is the basis of artificial intelligence. We will use Google's Teachable machine to teach our computer to distinguish between objects like lemon and banana and learn how AI works. So before we start with Teachable machine, let's understand conceptually what is artificial intelligence. So in traditional computing, you have a computer, and to this computer, you gave a set of instructions, a computer program, which is also called an algorithm. So you gave a set of instructions to the computer to say that whenever the computer gets some input or it gets some data input, the algorithm tells the computer what the computer is supposed to do with the data, and the computer then processes the data based on the instructions it gets, and it produces the desired result. So for example, you input data about all the height of all the students in your class, and you gave a set of instructions on how to calculate average height, then the computer would tell you what is the average height of students in your class. But in an artificially intelligent machine that uses machine learning, you don't give an algorithm. Instead, you give lot of data. It is also called big data. And based on this very large volume of data, the computer itself learns the algorithm. So for example, in our case, we will show the computer lots of images of bananas and of lemons and of apples, etc. Once we have given this big data, lots and lots of images of bananas and apples and lemons, the computer will itself generate the algorithm of how to recognize a banana. Like banana, just like when you were a kid, you learned, you know, if it's yellow, it's longish with some black dots, etc., it's a banana. And then what we will do is, once we have given a lot of data to the computer and the computer has figured out the algorithm, then we will show the computer. We will show the computer a banana, a lemon or an apple, and the computer will tell us if that is a banana or an apple or a lemon, etc. When an AI computer tells you whether it thinks this image is a banana or an apple or a lemon, it also says how sure it is, because there is no guarantee. It's not like human intelligence, and even human intelligence can fail. So it will say that it thinks it's a banana, and it's like maybe it's 100% sure, maybe it's 99% sure, or maybe it's just 50% sure. So this is how, using machine learning, computer becomes artificially intelligent. We are going to use Teachable machine, which is a free tool provided by Google. So I have a model here, and later on I'll show you how to build it step by step. But just to explain the concept of artificial intelligence, I have trained an AI model that can recognize apple, lemon, banana, and zucchini. Now you have to understand, what we are saying here is that the computer, through the webcam or through a camera, will be able to recognize an object. Now this is a big thing, you know, we humans, if we see something, we know, oh, this is an apple or a lemon or a banana. But how does a computer figure it out? That is what AI is all about. Here I have trained the model, and here you can see my webcam. So if I bring an object to my webcam, so I'm going to get an apple here. So now if you can see the output, this AI model is telling me that this is an apple and it's 100% sure that it's an apple. Now let's try something else. So if I bring in a lemon, the system recognizes it and it says that it's a lemon and it's 100% sure. Now just see what is happening. To a computer, it's a round object, you know, it's a round object, and an apple and a lemon look pretty much same, you know, other than the color. But the machine is able to say that this is apple, this is an apple, and it's 100% sure. Let's try a banana. So I'm going to get a banana. So here we have a banana, and see, the machine is saying that it's 100% sure that it's a banana. And I'm going to bring a zucchini, and a zucchini in shape is quite similar to a banana, but the color and texture, etc., is different. But our AI based model is saying with 100% surety that it's a zucchini. So this is quite remarkable, that the machine is able to recognize, a computer is able to recognize what an object is. And as you can see right now, that the machine is struggling because there is nothing in front of the camera, and so it's just trying to figure out what it is. And so it's saying sometimes it thinks it's an apple, sometimes it thinks it's a lemon. And let's say I put my hand here, and if I make my hand long, you can see that it's trying to say that the shape of my hand right now kind of is between a zucchini and a banana, whereas if I make it more round, it is struggling between apple and a lemon. Yeah, so I'm saying that this is just to show you that how the computer is trying to figure out, that it's not saying with any certainty what this is. It's saying that, well, that object kind of looks like a lemon or an apple, but it's not very sure. What happens in an artificially intelligent system is that the more you train the model, the more inputs you provide, and the you know, like if I would have also trained it on my hand, then it would have said that this is a human hand, or this is Atul's hand. I could train the model like that. So I hope you understand what we are saying here about AI, that how artificially intelligent machines have a way to learn. That's why it is called a teachable machine, and AI is also called machine learning. That just like when you were a kid, you learned, you know, your ABCD, your 1, 2, 3, 4, and you learned this is an apple, this is a banana. So it's the same, you know, like I'm telling the computer A for apple, and the computer is saying, yes, that is very right, A for apple. Then I say, oh, well, B for banana. And the computer says, yeah, B for banana, it's 100% sure. And now let me teach you how to make an AI model. So here we are on Google's teachable machine, teachablemachine.withgoogle.com. So I click the get started button, and there are currently three types of AI models you can build with teachable machine. You can build a model such that the computer will recognize an image, or you can build an audio model that it will recognize some sounds, or even a pose model where you can teach the computer to recognize different poses. So we will start with an image project. So I get two options, standard image model or embedded image model, which is good for microcontrollers, but right now I'm just going to use the standard model. So now here we are in the interface where we have to train our model. So I'm going to first say, switch on the webcam. So now this is the webcam view. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to bring an apple, and I'm going to teach the machine to recognize an apple. So I'm saying the first one is apple. Then to train the machine, you have to click and hold this button called hold to record. And while recording, what you have to do is you have to slightly change the apple so that the machine has seen different views of the apple. So the more photographs you take, the better it is, but the more photographs you take, it's also going to take more time for the model to get trained. So I think we have got around 400 sample images of an apple, so that is fine. And next I'm going to take a lemon and I'm going to train the machine to recognize a lemon. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a second class and I'm going to say that this is a lemon, and then switch on the webcam and again hold this button, hold to record, and then just move my lemon slightly so that the machine has different views of lemon. So again, we have around 400 sample photographs. That is fine. Then I'm going to add one more class and I'm going to teach the machine to recognize a banana. So I'm going to bring a banana and I'm going to click the webcam to switch it on and then hold to record, and then just change the view of the banana a little. So again, I've taken 400 odd sample photographs, and then finally I'm going to bring a zucchini and I'm going to start add a new class. I'm going to call it zucchini, switch on the webcam, and then hold to record images. Turn the zucchini a little so that the AI machine has seen the zucchini in different angles, and that will train the model better. Now that we have enough sample images for apple, for banana, for lemon, and for zucchini, I'm going to say click this button which says train the model. There are advanced options, but right now we are just going to follow the simple ones. So now it's saying it's preparing training data, and it'll take some time for the model to get trained. So I'm going to pause the video and then come back once the model is trained. So our model is trained now, and as you can see right now in the webcam, I have a zucchini here, and the AI machine is saying that it's a zucchini and it's 100% sure that it's a zucchini. Let's try some other stuff that we just trained the model on. So here I've got a banana, and the machine is saying that it's 100% sure it's a banana. Let's try a lemon, and it's saying it's 100% sure it's a lemon. And this is where you have to understand that shape wise lemon and apple look pretty much similar, but if I bring an apple, it says it's 100% sure it's an apple. And if I try both, then you can see that the machine, depending upon, you know, how, what the machine is reading at that time. So if I bring the lemon, if I move it around, you can see that the machine is not very sure what's happening. So this is just to show you how the machine is. So artificial intelligent machines basically mean autonomous machines. Autonomous means machines that can take decisions on their own. And here the machine is trying to decide on its own whether this is a banana or this is an apple. But see the power of AI machines. So if I show a banana, it says with 100% confidence that it's a banana. But even if I show it a peel, this is a eaten banana, it's still sure it's a banana. It's 100% sure it's a banana. See, even if I change the, like if I do it like this, even then it's able to recognize it's a banana. But I mean, don't be fooled. It's not like the machine is always 100% sure. You know, that's the problem with AI machines, that it's a probabilistic model, that you, it'll say most likely it is like this. Okay. So a banana peel it's able to recognize, but if I put an eaten apple here, then see, it recognizes it as a lemon, and it's like almost 100% sure. So I'm saying the AI machines also make a mistake. Now it thinks it's a banana because it looks yellow and it looks like an elongated thing. You must understand both aspects, that it's such a fascinating thing that a computer, we just, this is called machine learning, we just taught the computer how to recognize these four objects. If I put some other object, then it also makes mistakes. It's thinking that it's probably a banana or maybe it's an apple. And how powerful this AI machine will be depends on how well you train the machine. So the more samples it has, the better the output. To train the machine even more, what you do is, if it gives you a wrong result, you feed that wrong result back into the machine and tell the machine that this was wrong. This was not a lemon or this was not a banana. And then the machine updates its algorithm, its image recognition algorithm in this case. So this idea of telling the machine it's wrong and then the machine updating itself is called recursive learning. And that makes an AI machine very powerful. So I hope you enjoyed this video about artificial intelligence and Google's Teachable Machine.